My name is Leslie, and I'm here to teach you the choreography that I made along with Gilbert Gonzalez, and this is part two. Now, if you haven't done the part one, I suggest looking that up. It's probably in the description. And practice that a little bit. We'll get started with part two. Now, we ended off with the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah? Now, moving on. Okay, so while we're here, we're going to start from, again, one, because this choreography starts with its counts on one. Now, it'll be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So, for this variation, it is from the variation of a showboat, which is simply a push it and you push it and you cross over, you know? That, if anyone can recall, is from the Shim Sham. Now, you can do kicks over. That is the very simple version of this. However, try to do the variation that I have presented you because it is the choreo, and also I just think it looks fun. And it'll add some style, it'll add to your vocabulary and repertoire of dancing. So, let's try it slow. It'll be 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now make sure that each time whenever you go push it and you push it, you can do with the hips, you can do just a simple like back and forth, but overall, make sure that you have your weight being distributed on either foot. Lift them up if you really have to. If it has to be dramatic in order for you to make the steps work out, good. If not, and you can add your own style to it, make it small, that's fine. But like I said, weight distribution. Okay, now it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And you're going to scoot. We started with the right, and our left should be either to the side or behind us, but this is how I usually do it. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The 5 will be your prep, and the 6 will be your scoot. And lift your left leg up if you have to on the 6. That's how I do it. But let's see. Try it with me. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You notice how I did a step outward because I have nowhere else to go. I just need to land to get to my balance, and also that moves on to the next step. Let's try it again, all together, and I'll see if I can do it slow. All right. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Also, keep in mind with this move, not only do I need to do something with my feet, I need to do something with my hands. It looks kind of boring and, I don't know, just not as enthusiastic or entertaining and overall not as fun if you don't do it with your hands. So you can do like something like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, or a punch in the air, because that's what I do out in front. Something out here, doesn't matter, as long as you give it some sort of shape into your dancing. I believe I mentioned this in the last video. All right, let's try again. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, now let's move on. We're gonna do the same side. And before I continue any further, let's remember that this is not mirrored to you, so anything that I do, it's gonna be flipped. So if I'm doing something with my right, or I say that it's my right, it's going to be your left, and vice versa on the other leg, right? Okay, so we are now here. My left leg is in front, and my right leg is to the side slash behind, kind of at an angle. And now, since we did the whole scoot, step, step, it should be back here. It should be on your right leg. And then we do it all again, just opposite side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Let's try it. Yeah, starting here. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. One more time. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. Lift it up, 7, 8. Yep. Okay, so the next move We just finished here. Now, we're going off to the next one. But instead of repeating everything within a full count of eight, exactly how it was, we're going to do the scoots on two even numbers, 2 and 6. If I were to demonstrate, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah? So, let's try it together. We just finished the scoop here, your second eight count from within this video. So, you know what? It might be easier if you started from here anyway. So act as if this were a basic for now. You know, the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And then you will move on to the next one, 7, 8, because it's easier to step that way. But see if you can scoot on 2. Try it with me. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah? Let's try it again, in case people caught off guard by that. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yep. Okay. Now next, once we just did the 1, 2, 3, 4, it'll be 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah? So, let's try it all together. We'll start from our left leg, how we started before, from the 2 over here, and then the scoot 6 over here. Just try it with me. If I have to demonstrate it for this one, that's fine. But if you can go along with me, excellent. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yep. All right. Again, one more time, and we'll move on. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, now, this is gonna require some balance, like I said before with the beginning of this whole choreography from the previous video. Now, we just scooted on 5, 6. Now, 7, 8, you're actually gonna hold. 7, 8. 8 is where you come down, all right? Now, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So that right there is called a box step. Yeah, it's pretty common in some other dances, but don't be alarmed by it. It looks a little, I don't know, twisty-turvy, foot going somewhere. It's very simple, I promise. So we just did the 5, 6, 7, 8. So we are currently on the weight of our right foot, and then left behind us. Now the left is coming. 1, 2 to the side. Then 3, 4, right to the back. 5, 6, left to the front, crossing over your right. And then 7, 8, left to the back, right, crossing over your left. I'll do it slow. We're just right here. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now, each step takes 2 counts, so take as much time as you need. Style it out if you want. So if you're right here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah? All right, let's try it together. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. One more time. And by the way, guys, if you need a pause throughout any of this, please do. Give it a couple of, you know, of tries. Give it a go once or twice. If you need to resume, excellent. I'll see if I can get at least 2 to 3 demonstrations, minimum 2. But yeah, let's continue. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, now once we're here, step out on 1 with your left, and it's going to transfer its weight. You're currently on your right foot, now 1, and then the song within the chorus
or at least the pre-chorus, I believe, if I remember correctly,
it's going to be very sharp on the evens of this eight count. So it'll be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay? So imagine like you're just really trying to punt something with your foot. There's not really any given name that I call this, and not one that I am aware of, but overall, just see if you can shimmy, take out your hip as much as you can. It's a very nice twist. I guess you can call it like a twist kick in a way. See if you can twist your foot as well and not just your hip. It's, I don't know, it looks more attractive that way. But yeah, it'll be step 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Whether you want to point your foot or not, that is up to you. Sometimes I'll point my foot. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Sometimes I won't. All right, your choice, your style, make it your own. It's your dance. You're just following a choreography. Yeah? All right, let's try it with counts. So we just crossed over. You know, the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, now let's try it again. But this time with the twist kick. All right? 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And it's one of the best things that you can do for your balance. See if you can balance yourself while giving it a nice pulse. Remember, this entire choreo just about has a nice pulse. So don't throw it out and forget it. Okay? Just right here. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And don't forget those arms, okay? All right, now I'll move on. So we're at here. Now, the trick for the next eight count, again, you have to have good balance. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It's not gonna have to be held, but it's definitely gonna, I guess it could be held. Yeah, technically. 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You're doing a whole box step again, but the other way around, yeah? And instead of going out to the side, you're going to cross over from the step, that kick, that ha, 8, the 8 is up here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Make sure each step is within the evens. Same with the kicks, they're evens as well. It's a rule of thumb in swing dancing and solo jazz. It's kind of a pet peeve of many if you do things on the odds. And sometimes it can be found within the music that there are odd numbers. Sometimes. Very rarely, occasionally. It's probably not gonna be there. So evens, 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 especially when you're clapping. Okay. All right. So we just started here. We're on 8. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, we're moving on the odds, and we're definitely finishing every step out on an even, okay? Let's try it again. Get that balance. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Down, right, 1, 2, 3, 4, crossing your left over. 5, 6, your right is behind, having all the full weight. 7, 8, you just stepped out with your left. Okay? All right, now that we're here, now this one, you give me some room, because this step, it might be tricky for some, but it is very rhythmically inclined for those who are trying this out. See if you can get every point within the song, because how do I explain this? Whenever you have a full eight count, some people, they like to put beats within a full eight count on evenly spread apart. So let's say if we were trying to do it on the twos. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now this one in particular, because of the rhythm of the song, it'll be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah? And that's usually how you can find rhythm within your steps in swing dancing. Like, for example, if I were to do an eight count in Lindy. But that's another class for another time. Okay, so moving on, we are going to do the move. Now, remember, we are on our left. We are on our left for the weight. Now it's gonna be a hop. One, two, a three, four. Yeah? Now, let me explain that a little slower, because for some it just looks like, whoa, she did a turn and a hop. What do I do? Now, the rhythm, remember what I said? One, two, a three, four. Yeah? So it'll be five, six, seven, eight. One, two, a three, four. Yeah? Let's try that again. Now, if you can, do it with me. If not, give it a moment, or don't explain it to yourself all too well. Like, don't worry, I'm gonna explain it even further. Just try to do it with me. A five, six, seven, eight. One, two, a three, four. Yeah? All right. Now, if we were to do this very slowly, like I said, weight is on our left. We're gonna do a hop on our right. Make sure you're trying to rotate over your left shoulder. So a hop, one, and then two. If you can do this really slow, I commend you on balance. Anyway, one, two. Yeah, that is the rhythm within the song. It's not a rhythm that I'm making up, but it does help. So it's one, two, a three, four. You're going to hop again on the three so that you're able to turn around. A three, four. Yeah? Now, let's try to do that slow together if you can. All right. A five, six, seven, eight. One, two, a three, four. All right, moving on. Now, you're gonna actually pause on five, six. Sometimes I'll lift up my leg to make it just look a little showy. Do some sort of a pose with your arms if you want to. For me, it's a must. Sometimes we'll see. Now, you have two counts to hold. A five, six, seven, eight. So remember that rhythm I said? A one, two, a three, four, five, six, a seven, eight. So, if you were to clap that along as I would do it, you'd see that the rhythm matches with my footsteps. Let's try it all together. I will call out some of the moves. I'll see if I can add counts, but then one demonstration, I'm just gonna do complete counts, okay? All right. A five, six, seven, eight. One, two, a three, four, five, six, a seven, eight. Yeah, so it's seven, eight. See if you can go forward with that left leg, not the right one. One more time. Five, six, seven, eight. Turn, tip, a three, four, five, six, a seven, eight. Yeah, seven, eight. See if you can pick it up. Now that we're here, we just did a triple step, and again, remember, pick up your weight. If you don't, it's gonna look a little, I don't know, like someone's trying to shuffle their shoes and running across the floor. Not within dancing, but you know how some people do, like drag their feet. Don't do that, pick up your feet. Okay, now, seven, eight, one, two, three, four. Now I know some of you have done the jive from, I believe it was Sammy's video. Now, it's the same thing. Step, forward, pivot, pivot. You're only gonna do that coming pivot, pivot. That's it, yeah? So we just did seven, eight, one, two, three, four. So your weight is already gonna be on your left leg. You're gonna step with your right. One, two is a turn. As you're pivoting, yep. One, two, and sometimes I'll snap, sometimes I won't. Just, again, make shapes with your arms, because if you don't, it's gonna look boring, you're just gonna look like you're walking and moseying, and if you want, that's fine, make it look chill. But I don't know, there's something about it whenever somebody adds arms, adds its own style. Okay, so seven, eight, one, two, three, four. If you wanna add more like pizzazz with your legs, one, two, three, four, yep. Do it, but see if you can do it within the counts. Okay? So one, two, three, four, five, six. Now, you notice how I'm going a bit lower. There's a reason for that. And it's because the next move, once you're finished with the seven, you're immediately gonna pop up on eight. On your tiptoes, if you even wanna jump, that's perfectly fine, as long as it's a very sharp eight. It's not just a little high, like very slow, make it quick. Okay? So we just did one, sorry, I'm gonna count it out first. Five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Now you're gonna take your time with it. Remember, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Okay, make it sharp. Now once you're here, you're gonna lean toward this way. And it's gonna start just with steps, that's it. But let's try it from the beginning, from the triple step, the walk, pivot walk. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. That's the next step. And it's a full eight count. It looks like a lot of steps, just little ones here and there, but I promise you it's easy. So you're up here, eight, eight. One, two, three, four. So the three, we call that a mambo step because it looks like one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. All you're doing is just a side step. That's it. And then a back, and then a forward, but then you hit that eight. So we're up here. Five, six, seven, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Now, as long as you're doing right after the one, two, three, four, as long as you're doing that weight shift, and as long as you're doing some sort of a grapevine, you've got the picture, okay? Sometimes I'll do it out in front, sometimes I'll do it out in back. But just to give somebody direction, let's see if we can do it forward and then backwards, okay? And that will be on the counts. Five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. It's on the odds. So it'll be five and seven. Let's try doing it again. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Okay. Now, for this next one, it's actually very interesting because remember when I said that all of the moves start out on, one for this choreo? Well, this one in particular, I guess you could say that it still starts out on one, but at the same time, it's just a bit of a debate because this one's gonna be a kickball change sort of motion, but it starts on eight instead of one. So remember, and also you're gonna tell when you actually need to kick, because remember when I said those very defined, sharp moments on the eight counts? That's where you're gonna kick. That's it. Seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Make it sharp, if you can. Woo! All right, now, moving on. You just hit the eight. It'll be and one, two, and three, four. Yeah? So, if I were to break that down slowly, because it speeds up very quickly, so it's gonna look a bit strange. Eight and one, two and three, four. Yeah? You do use ands in counts sometimes, but just remember, as long as it is explained thoroughly and also whenever you can catch it. So, eight, and one, two, and three, four, five, six, seven, eight. So this one, it's just a kickball change, kickball change, kickball change. Three, four, golf blocks. So that'll be two of them. This is the motion of it. Kick, ball change, kick, ball change. If you can have it out to the side as best as you can, makes it for a more dramatic effect. Hop, hop, kick and hop, kick and hop, kick, step, step, kick, step, step, kick. Mm-hmm. Let's try it together. But if you need a pause just to get it real quick, kick, step, step, kick, step, step. That's all you gotta do until you finally hit it. All right? Now it counts. Eight and two, three, and, or excuse me. Eight and one, two, and three, four, five, six, seven, one, two. So moving on. We just did the eight and one, two, and three, four. Now, fall off the locks. This will be the four, five, six, seven, eight. This is what you might see in the Tranky do, the very beginning. It starts on eight, one, two, three, four. But instead, it's gonna start off with your left. Now, once you hit it here, three, four, you just ended the kickball changes.
three, four, five on your left, six on your right, seven, you'll cross over in front of your right, eight, kick on your right foot. And make it sharp, because this is one of those counts where it's like, bam, eight. Four, five, six, seven, eight. For me, as a variation, if you can, instead of just doing the ha, fall, because remember you are falling off the log, see if you can add a little pivot with your foot. Sometimes I do this in my dancing, well, most of the time. So it'll be four, five, six, seven, eight. Yeah. It'll make your body turn a little bit to the side. Again, it's personal style. You don't have to do this, but I recommend it. Four. Let's start from there. It'll be one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Try it again. Five, six, or excuse me. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Yep. All right, now once we're here, it'll be one, two, so a rock step, three, and four, five, six, seven, eight. Yep. Okay. All right, let's start it from off the log again. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, and four, five, six, seven, eight. Yeah. All right. Now, that's actually all of the choreo. And it never concerned me for a second that we should redo all of it. So, from the very tippy top, if you can, and if it's already too late, you should probably at some points restart the video so that you can just do it all over again. But we'll do it now. Okay, so we started at the very beginning. Five, six, seven, eight. Yeah, so we're here. Very tippy top. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. 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 One, two, a three, four, five, six, a seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. And one, two, and three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, and four, five, six, seven, eight. Oh my gosh, that's a mouthful. Now, let's see if we can do it one more time. And then later on, we'll see if we can do it with the rest of the music. Yeah? Okay, from the beginning. Well, part two beginning. Five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, 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 five, six, seven, eight. One, two, a three, four, five, six, a seven. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. 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 Oh. Okay. Now, let's see if we can do it with some music. But with the music, we're gonna start it from the very beginning. That means from part one. So, see what you can do. Try to follow along as best as you can. If you need to go over it by yourself a couple times, awesome. And remember to keep it the tempo.
Got a good beat, and that's the main thing to make you complete. 'Cause everyone's swinging today, so we call it.
guys, thank you so much for joining me with this choreo. I hope you enjoyed it as much as I had fun making it, along with Gilbert Gonzalez. He takes at least half of the credit on this one. Anyway, if you have any questions, you can DM me or you can message me in the group chat. I'm in the official UTSA Swing Dance Society group chat in GroupMe, as well as the Swing Shenanigans group chat. If you want to DM me or if you just want to have a question open out there in the group chat, please do. They might have the same question and it's great to get everybody involved. Also, please join us for the Zoom Q&A just right after this class. And without further ado, thank you so much. I hope to see y'all again soon. Please be safe out there. I love you and keep dancing. Bye.